സുനിൽ അറോറ ഇപ്പോൾ മാധ്യമങ്ങളെ കാണുകയാണ് തത്സമയ സംപ്രേഷണത്തിലേക്ക്.
We had come from Puducherry. Puducherry we came to Chennai, and from Chennai we came to Trivandrum. As is the norm with the commission, we started with a interactive meeting with political parties, and after the meeting of political parties, actually prior to that, the new CS and DGP, the CS Mr. Vishwas Mehta, along with the DGP, because DGP had to cover the PM's rally, so they had also come to pay a courtesy call to the commission. And then we started with political parties. After political parties, we had a very in-depth meeting with the collectors, SPs, police commissioners, and other senior police officers. That ended in the night. It took 5-6 hours for that meeting, understandably so. Then today we conducted a meeting with the central and state enforcement agencies, enforcement and regulatory agencies, after which we sat with the chief secretary, the incoming chief secretary, and senior officers of the state administration. And finally, wherever commission goes, we come to the media, another most important component, pillar of democracy, to A, to brief them, B, to try and kind of reply to their queries and questions. The term of State Assembly in Kerala is due to expire on 1st June 2021. Elections are due for 140 ACs, 124 general ACs, 14 SC and 2 ST ACs. Kerala elections have consistently seen a high voter participation, be it in a state assembly, 2016 elections 77.35%, Lok Sabha elections 77.67%. This is obviously thanks to the very high literacy rate of Kerala and the very high levels of general awareness. Commission, as mandated by the Constitution of India, is committed to conduct the forthcoming elections in a free, fair, peaceful, accessible, ethical, inducement-free and COVID-safe elections. We can't help the prevalence of COVID, that is for the state government, but whatever precautions are to be required for this, including social distancing norms, etc., that we'll do. That I'll elaborate more later. At the same time, Commission always endeavors to ensure the participation of new voters, women, persons with disabilities, and senior citizens. As you are all aware, during the pandemic period of 2020, when it was at peak in most other parts of the country, low in Kerala, Commission successfully conducted elections in Bihar Assembly. It was a very difficult exercise. The population of Bihar is almost more than double of the population of Kerala. We had 70,000 polling booths. We created 33,000 more polling booths, or what we call auxiliary polling stations, in the context of social distancing norms. Just like in Kerala, we have 25,000 existing polling booths, round off karke bata raha hu, and we have created 15,000 more, which means 40,000 now, auxiliary polling stations. have already been CEO and the DMs, they are working on that. Actually, in the, before we conducted the elections in Bihar Assembly, we did a bit of test the grounds, the Rajya Sabha elections, elections to some legislative councils. Of course, there's a limited electorate there, but that was our way of kind of testing the waters and then going for a much bigger election. While announcing Bihar elections, I said into the press that this is a commission, is for commission, it is not a leap in the dark, but a leap of faith. It was not said as a some kind of aphorism. Our officers, senior officers, Umesh Sinhaji, who is not here, Secretary General, and Chandrabhushan, who is in charge of Bihar, they had very intensively gone into all aspects of elections. And only then, when we were satisfied, and that too after our two-day visit there, just like we are here, that yes, we can hold the election. And I must tell you, friends, that the administration of Bihar, they really rose to the occasion, just as we are very hopeful that the administration of Kerala shall rise to the occasion, because Kerala always had very sound administrative traditions. And despite the fact that at least three district magistrates themselves had COVID, but they rejoined their duties and conducted the elections. One divisional commissioner had COVID. She continued to work after getting, when she got cured, luckily before the elections. One IGP, field IGP, unfortunately passed away due to COVID and other comorbidities. Despite that, the turnover of Bihar, it's lower than Kerala, of course, but it was higher than the last assembly elections there and slightly higher than the last Lok Sabha elections. When we talk to the political parties, I will give you the main concerns raised by them. Cutting across the party lines, the political parties, the representatives asked the commission to schedule the assembly election dates, keeping in view the local festival dates of Easter, Vishu, Ramadan coming up in April. We told them that in fact commission takes all these factors into account while deciding the dates, the local sensitivities, the local festivals, and all other assorted features, the exams of the students. For example, our Secretary General, Mr. Sinha, had a series of meetings with the chairman of CBSC and conveyed the concerns of commission in terms of as to when the life of assembly ends, and then how do we optimally get the schools and other buildings, etc. And I am glad to report to you that CBSE they gave due heed to our concerns while announcing the dates of exam. Given COVID concerns, most party representatives voiced concern about campaign norms, mass gatherings, specific voting arrangements, and asked that the postal ballot procedures should be monitored and implemented with due diligence.
തെരഞ്ഞെടുപ്പ് ഏപ്രിൽ 14 മുമ്പ് വേണമെന്ന നിർദ്ദേശമാണ് കേന്ദ്ര തെരഞ്ഞെടുപ്പ് കമ്മീഷനോട് സംസ്ഥാന സർക്കാർ ഉന്നയിച്ചിരിക്കുന്നത്. രാഷ്ട്രീയ പാർട്ടികളുമായും വിവിധ തലങ്ങളിലുള്ളവരുമായും വിശദമായ ചർച്ച നടന്നുവെന്നാണ് സുനിൽ അറോറ പറഞ്ഞത്. ജൂൺ 1 നിലവിലെ നിയമസഭയുടെ കാലാവധി തീരും. കേരളത്തിലെ തെരഞ്ഞെടുപ്പിൽ ഉയർന്ന പോളിംഗ് ശതമാനം രേഖപ്പെടുത്താറുണ്ട്. കോവിഡ് കാലത്ത് ബീഹാർ നിയമസഭാ തെരഞ്ഞെടുപ്പ് നടത്തിയ അനുഭവം കമ്മീഷനുണ്ട്. കൂടുതൽ പോളിംഗ് സ്റ്റേഷനുകൾ ഉണ്ടാകും എന്നുള്ള കാര്യവും സുനിൽ അറോറ വ്യക്തമാക്കി. അദ്ദേഹത്തിന്റെ വാർത്താ സമ്മേളനം ഇപ്പോൾ പുരോഗമിക്കുകയാണ്. 24